thing.
Okay, you want me to join?
Yeah. So most welcome, Pratima ji.
Thank you very much.
It's already 8:30. I'm going to call the meeting to order. And before that, I'm going to mute everyone. Speakers are requested to unmute themselves when they come on to speak, and mute when they finish. So I'm going to mute everyone. Meeting call to order. Please rise for national anthem. Very good morning to everyone. Before proceeding, I have certain announcements. Today we have a club fellowship, which was fun-filled and a lot of excitement was there. It was hosted by Rotarian Ganesh Natarajan, but actually it was coordinated and conducted by Neeru Goyal in different way. And the one more attraction, which was the surprise by Jhelum Chauhal, very well coordinated by Prerna Gaikwad, Secretary Club. So thank you, Neeruji, thank you, Ganeshji, thank you, Prerna, thank you, Jhelum, for lovely evening, which is unforgettable. So please give very big hand to all the four. And another announcement is regarding Rotary Club Pune Riverside has come up with a new concept that is called Sanjeevani Riverside. This is a flagship through which we have targeted to empower 500 teachers and about 10,000 students in Rotary year 2020-21. The objective is to empower the teachers with bringing a lot of awareness, bringing knowledge and bringing skill sets in them, which are relevant and related to their areas. First such talk was organized last Saturday. The topic was emotional wellness. That was by Group Captain Ashwini Kumar Bhako, Vishesh Seva Medal. He's basically pilot, psychotherapist, an aviation consultant. He spoke very well, and the feedback what we have received from the teachers and students, that's amazing. I have shared, in fact, we have shared the recording link on the group. So request all the members to kindly look for that in their own convenient time. I would like to extend special thanks for that to Rakesh Ralan, Umesh Jalan, Deepak Gupta, Sanjay Merchant, Prerna Gaikwad, Kiran, because they have been, in fact, this project is going to be spearheaded by Umesh, supported by Rakesh, coordinated by Sanjay, and finally, the Prerna and Kiran. So it's lovely. We are proud that this is going to happen, and Next session will be somewhere in first week of October. Not taking much time, we have very amazing speaker today. Very august, very significant talk we have today. So I would like to invite Neeru Goyal, Director Service Project. But before that, I would like to extend my warm welcome to all the participants, and particularly the President Downtown Parsi ji, Mr. Patel, and other guests who have joined today. So not taking much time, over to Neeru ji.
Thank you, President, for giving me this special privilege of introducing the Grihalakshmi of the most glorious family of Pune, a dear friend and a guest speaker of today's meeting, Mrs. Pratima Kirloskar. We all already have got her profile and know what a dynamic personality she is. Here I want to share some aspects of her personality which are not mentioned in her formal profile. I myself run my house adhering 5S, place for everything, everything at its place, and first come, first serve, Kaizen, all Japanese system. But I was aghast to see with the perfection she is following them in her house, and this is the secret that she can handle so much in life. She is very good at recreating spaces and giving a magical touch to the whole interior. How she has given a unique touch to her heritage house in Mahabaleshwar, that is amazing. Indian weavers are her passion, weaves are her passion, and she maintains a special relation with the weavers of around, supporting and helping them regularly all the time, especially in this COVID time. She creates beautiful table linen. Her creation is so royal that I still do not have the heart to open that table gift pack, which she had given me 3 years back. Another field she is deeply involved is mentoring the startups. She is a founder member of the Indus Entrepreneurs and Innovation Society that helps entrepreneurs one-on-one in networking and nurturing. In COVID time, she is managing well without a cook. That is another expertise, because she has changed and adhered the total American system. In fact, whole family is giving time to cooking and having a blast. She is advanced level Reiki and pranic healer. Now I want to end her intro by complimenting and asking what she uses to have a beautiful, radiant, shining skin and such a pretty face. I present to you, friends, Mrs. Pratima Kirloskar.
Thank you, Neeru. Thank you for that wonderful introduction. And good morning to everyone. Thank you for calling me today.
Very good morning, and more welcome to you, ma'am.
Thank you so much. May I have my slides, please? Next slide, please. Kirloskar Brothers was started as a partnership in 1888 and went on to becoming a company in 1920. This year, we have completed 100 years of being a public listed company, but 132 years of existence. I think to survive through extenuating circumstances, one needs a particular mindset. And I don't believe the motive can only be profit. Because if that were to happen, in your lowest and gloomiest times, people would have just left you if you were unable to pay them. So then what is it about your management style that people stand by you? Could it be giving people freedom to explore their potential by cajoling them, or giving them a long rope to hang themselves? Or compassion could possibly be the other attribute. Next slide, please. Over the last 100 years, KBL has consistently been delivering value to its shareholders. KBL is not a company whose shares you buy because they give you a huge return on the stock exchange. But on the other hand, it's a share that gives you a dividend year after year. We missed it during the Depression once, when we recalled some material that was exported to Africa in 1937. The company has given an uninterrupted dividend for 83 years after that. Next slide, please. Over the last 100 years, KBL has been nurturing a special bond with its employees. The family broke barriers of caste divide to unite its co-workers, and hence becoming a cohesive group. Since the company was set in rural Maharashtra, there were no trained workers, but that meant each person needed to be trained. The subsequent years, these people, albeit from an underprivileged background, gained respect and status in the area after getting a livelihood, and their next generations got upgraded into qualified doctors and engineers. Obviously, they had high regard for the Kirloskar family. I have to bring something to your notice here, that in manufacturing, it is easier to upgrade in one generation compared to IT, because in IT, you inherently have to be educated. Whereas in manufacturing, you could be a fitter, you could be someone who has less qualification, but with some training, you can get a good salary in manufacturing companies. That means you can educate your children in the next generation. But that does not happen in an IT company. You inherently need to be educated. So there was a feeling of one large family, and everyone's problems were also the problem of the Kirloskar family. There was loyalty to the family of another order. This became a reciprocal feeling the Kirloskar family enjoyed and still enjoys the goodwill of that area. Our founder, Sri Lakshman Rao Kirloskar, and his brothers, his sons, and their wives were the highly evolved, compassionate human beings behind all the success. One trait that is worth noting was that people who worked for the company were willing to go any distance for the promoter. They stood by him through thick and thin. Finally, a leader can only give direction. It's the people below, in the front line, who act as foot soldiers. This is the only trait and mindset that has enabled this company to weather the tide. There are some people in the company who have been with us for four generations. That is rare. Which brings me to say that this helped the family in fighting wars with near empty coffers, but the goodwill to the brim. Next slide, please. Over the last 100 years again, KBL has been reinvesting in its business. If you see our journey, the founder got a kit to put together a cycle. He made a cycle and he used his English speaking skill to teach people how to use the cycle. And he charged for teaching. This led him to start a business hiring out cycles, to finally having a joint venture with an English company to make and sell cycles in India. Next slide, please. Several businesses were gotten into as the opportunity arose, right from making buttons, boxes, piped furniture, iron benches, maternity hospital metal furniture for the operation theaters, chaff cutters, tawas, iron mortar and pestle, spring beds. I still have a spring bed that is 100 years old and the springs are perfectly fine. Until we went into pumps in 1926. Now, we had created an asset-heavy business. So as long as one is in asset-light businesses, one can be agile. When we went into asset-heavy businesses, we could only innovate or expand and integrate vertically forward or backward. Hence, we went into all prime moving equipment that pumps needed, like motors, alternately generators. Pumps could push compressed air, hence compressors and refrigeration systems. Every time we had money, it would get plowed back into the business by adding some new technology or a joint venture. The philosophy was to keep the price low and enhance your market share. Next slide, please. There has been a long learning out of each business cycle over the last 100 years. We were focusing on products until we came to a realization that since we already have huge assets, we could take on projects that were large without finding the need to add any more assets, thereby getting a higher value on capital. We went into huge projects like the Sardar Sarovar project in Gujarat that gave water to 3 crore people. Next slide. Senegal and Laos were rice importers, but after the irrigation systems became rice exporters. The impact was huge. Returns were good too, but in our exuberance, we spread ourselves too thin, took too many projects. The state government could not pay us back. Hence, lots of money in crores was stuck to the point that we nearly became bankrupt in the years 2008 and 2010. So we had to rethink our product mix, review all our contracts. Working with the government can have its own uncertainties. We stressed on our products again and slowly overcame this huge setback. Huge lessons learned, fingers burnt, but the spirit went on. We are a niche player in our vertical. That was the mindset of our founders. But sometimes you need to expand. We were in all kinds of water. We are in all kinds of water. Clear water, dirty water, seawater, wastewater primarily. But we make pumps and valves that can handle all fluids, hence are versatile. Our range of products is huge, from a small pump house to a completely engineered system used by a municipal corporation to supply water. In Gujarat, we have lifted 630,000 liters of water per second, up 70 meters, and brought it into arid areas. Next slide. Over the last 100 years, preserving cash and investing in technology has seen us through the tough times. The point I'm making is that it's not only a pandemic that can get you cash strapped. It could be your own doing. It could be markets crashing, banks turning bankrupt, like the Great Depression. Ultimately, any situation that can have the same effect, irrespective of the cause. The learning was to save your cash. Do not splurge, nor allow people in your organization to do so. That's why we are so low profile. I don't believe any youngsters would even know who we are. We make our presence felt by our absence, our products working silently and reliably in the background. If the water supply to the city were to stop, you would remember us. Every time you have cash, spend on technology that will help you depend less on people or their knowledge. Create a system approach rather than a people-centric approach. When you start with nothing, it's easier to understand where one would be if you fail. It's not unknown to you. However, that logic worked with the generations before us. May not apply now. We need to see what rules would apply to each generation. So you try to pivot the business when the time is challenging. Next slide, please. Agility in business strategy is crucial for survival. So one is compelled to make changes in strategy with the times. The world was focused on material security. There was a short supply of raw material. The Spanish flu focused on people security and knowledge management. Liberalization, it focused on global competition, changes to products, changes to methods of production, managing cash flows while enhancing capital expenditures to break out of the licensed capacity and move towards real demand. We needed to make radical changes in product mix to redefine the company, especially when the state governments were unable to fund infrastructure projects. We had to focus on enhancing product sales, focus on being able to offer and sell products without proportionate increase in people. The ability to manage cash when 70% of your business was not able to supply predictable cash flows. Making hard decisions with customers to chase them to pay up or for managing cash, and often leading to a pushback from customers. The ability to manage knowledge and apply knowledge discreetly so that new generations can be introduced into the business with the same level of knowledge as the older staff members. The ability to enhance production at a time when cash is scarce because of the rise in product sales to offset the decline of projects. Cash management was completely necessary. During good times, I'd say focus on being able to change the business and its products by investing in the future in terms of products and manufacturing technologies. But in the bad times, keeping a very tight leash on cash. Technologies like 3D printing, a pump configuration software, putting in logic for anticipating sales like a regression, for remote repairs by using augmented reality, were all developed before the crisis. We spent hugely on IT infrastructure, because of which during the nuclear sanctions, we were able to continue without the support of large US companies, as we were part of the India's nuclear program. What's important was we were luckily ahead of the curve. Essentially, stay ahead of the curve, even in good times. Invest in technology. Our team has all kinds of diverse people, risk takers, sprinters, marathoners, and you need them all. So develop a mindset and keep an eye on costs, even in the good times, because bad times come without warning. And there, this is on the macro level. Next slide. We have always continued with the business of doing good. Another attribute that I believe that has helped us was goodwill in India as well as overseas, where we have 60% of our manufacturing facilities. Next slide. In India, we work in and around our factories in the field of health and education for women and children, running schools and the primary healthcare centers and maternity home, where we do deliveries for a very tiny sum of money. Other than the midday meals in school, we do an Annapurna program for underprivileged children during the time when there is no school. We send rations of wheat, rice, pulses, oil, sugar, spices, and food grains enough to last the entire holidays, especially long holidays, when the midday meals program is not functional. We have distributed similar food packets during the COVID crisis. Next slide. We lend our expertise and knowledge during the Thailand cave rescue, and we're recognized by the King of Thailand. In addition to this, we assisted the government in the Kerala floods, Sangli floods, all have created goodwill. I have to mention that in Thailand, there was no shortage of pumps. There was Elon Musk who had come with his pumps, but they didn't need pumps. The pumps were too large to get into the caves. What they needed was knowledge of the terrain to see how water levels change, because the caves are uneven and the water level in different parts of the cave are different. And I think that is our specialty. So our team from all over the world, from Netherlands, from England, from Pune, from Kiroskarwadi, had gone there to assist them in this. So they needed that technical know-how. Next slide, please. In UK, we do an apprenticeship building program in the large employer category. We sponsor young students for getting engineering degrees and train them in our factories to understand the factory environment. This creates goodwill for our products with their new employers, and we retain a few while the others join other industries. In the US, we reskill war veterans through our Heroes First Foundation so that they can be absorbed in industry, making us an important arm of the country to train and rehabilitate war veterans. Hence, the country's recognition by identifying our company in the US as an essential service. So hence, all through COVID in America, our company could function, whereas many companies were stopped. So some values like say what you mean and mean what you say, value all kinds of people, while only a small percentage of people are in their fourth generation, but people see that there is a congruence of words spoken and actions taken and a consistency of thought process. So people observe promoters and your behavior. If the company is not paying salaries to the staff while promoters are enjoying themselves, it's not really such a good thing to be. You need to create respect, and it has to be commanded and not demanded. So only your behavior will do that. So we are a conservative company and we do not splurge unnecessarily. So you don't hear of us. We rather invest that money in technology. With this shutdown, all our factories in India were shut. But we are still working on VC planning, because planning is a very critical part. Because on a daily basis, there is firefighting and there's no time to do mapping activities. So at this time, we have done a lot of mapping activities in our company. Finally, I have to humbly say, sometimes the universe conspires to help us. Bottom line is, you need to have faith too. There is only so much one can do. And having good values does not hurt. It builds your character and personality. Next slide, please. And thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, Pratimaji. It was very interesting, and there are a lot of takeaway coming in the morning and speaking on Kirloskar's 100 years. It's in fact, we have grown knowing the name of Kirloskar, and you know, take the name of any pump, it is Kirloskar. So very high regard to you and the Kirloskars. Now it is time for question answer, and I would request Rotarian Sanjay Merchant to please moderate. Over to Sanjay.
Yeah, thank you, Colonel Saab. Anybody has any questions? In fact, Pratimaji, when we were sitting once with Anand Mahindra, he always said that to do business in India is very good, because I've been through 4 recessions and China has never been through any of them. So you learn a lot when you do business in India.
That's true. It gives you a different sort of resilience, you know. That is why we have learned over the years that you just trap your cash, don't spend it. Because if you spend everything off, you never know, in a bad time, you can get stuck.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Any questions, anybody? Hadi, Vikram?
Yes, I have a question, if I may.
Yes, Vikram. I'll take you next, Umesh. Vikram, go ahead.
Just a sec. Morning. My question is that, you know, how Kirloskar has such a strong and rock-solid reputation in the country as well as across the world. How do you, we have lots of companies like that in India who have a very strong, high integrity reputation. How does one leverage that reputation to get, to get the rest of the corporate world to contribute to giving back to community? How do we use that brand or that, reputation to do that?
No, I didn't understand. So are you saying, that if you have a reputation, how do you give back to the community? Is that what you're asking?
I'm saying, how do you use and leverage your reputation? Because your reputation is all pervasive. Everybody knows you. The brand is recognizable. So when you when you go and visit another company and you say that, look, we want to do this for the community in your area, will you contribute? That's an extremely effective a way of getting other people to join you in giving back to the community. But have you found that you can effectively leverage that reputation and brand? Or do you think that people don't really get motivated just because they see somebody, for example, if you look at Tata doing something, would other companies in the area get
a chance? I get it. Charged, but they get a chance to do it. Yeah.
Charged, not a chance, but yeah. You know, get motivated to do something.
That's right. No, certainly. You know what? It was both sides. Because you do work, you get a reputation, and because you have a reputation, you get more work. So it's a cycle. You know. So you need to start somewhere. And what I have seen, you're dead right. When you work as a non-Kirloskar, it makes a very big difference. It does, because I have worked in several NGOs as a non-Kirloskar. And I do see that people suspect you. They wonder, why would you want to do this for me? What is in it for you that you're doing it for me? Yes, that is a question that happens. But people get over it. If you are consistently doing work for them, they get over this. So I don't think that should stop you from doing good work. See, what has happened is, in our country, many of these, many people, they say they're going to do something and they're unable to do it. And they've actually leveraged the villagers. And I think that's where villagers feel that they're actually using me for something. So I think that is the issue we have in our country. But the minute we are able to overcome that, I don't see that if we do good, people don't come to you. They do.
Thank you. But actually, I was asking whether, you know, it would be effective for somebody like, for an organization like Rotary to say, join hands with a brand like yours and then go to the community and say, look, this is what we are doing. Will you also give? And does that work?
It certainly would. It does. I do believe we have that credibility. So I do believe.
Thank you. I hope that happens then.
And I know I'd be happy to work. Really, I'd be happy to work. So there's not a problem with that.
Thank you. Thank you.
Umesh, your question, please.
Pratima ji, thank you very much for taking us through the Kirloskar journey. I see that you being in the pump industry, the country has got a good fight with China. So, and obviously you have faced many challenges in dealing with China products. So I want to know how you face overcome those challenges and continue to carry your journey.
That's a very good question, actually. Our products are more expensive than the Chinese products, for sure. But then our products are, in my opinion, over-engineered. They last so many years that you wonder when it's going to die. So the point is, the Chinese product will not last more than 3 years. Sometimes there are lots of breakdown issues. And so though you pay a higher amount, you can forget about your pump that it is working in the background. And that is the advantage that we've had over China. Now, having said that, I'd say the market is very price sensitive. So we have in that range products that are also equally price sensitive. And if you compare quality to quality, there's no comparison. Because what happens many times is a farmer, our pump has what is called as they're more efficient. That means they'll consume less electricity. So if you are paying for electricity on your own, then it is going to worry you if you get a pump that will give you all the other duty points, but your electricity consumption will be huge. Now for farmers, many times electricity is free. So it is irrelevant to them what pump they use. But the day they have to pay for electricity, they will all change to this because they will be bleeding. That is the only difference, what I can see.
Thank you.
Milin, you have a question? You can unmute yourself. Milin? Till the time anybody else has a question?
Sanjay, can I ask a question?
Yeah, Anuradha, go ahead, please.
Yeah. Pratima,
yes.
You know, I'm a Maharshian, you are also Maharshian. We yes. all have, all our life, have been hearing people saying that Maharshians do not know how to do business. A Marathi person can't do well. And I think all of us had to struggle to prove that it is not so. And probably have to work extra hard to win the hearts and the confidence of the customers. Do you agree with me? I'm talking about something like, you know, maybe not today, but 20, 25 years back. Was it not true?
You know, I don't think it was Maharashtra, not Maharashtra, but yes, I agree with you. Maharashtrians are not good in business. If you compare a Maharashtrian to any other business community, we are really bad. Because we are more into education, and I think our mindset is very, very strange. So I would say that, yes, to answer your question in a short way, Maharashtrians are not great business people. However, after having said that, I'll tell you that with Lakshman Rao Kirloskar, he was just enterprising, and there are enough, but Maharashtrians are enterprising. I will tell you, if you see Pune, if there is anyone who has to stand up for some values or stand up for something, it will be a Puneri who will stand up. Even if you see the Peshwas, they were managing from Pune. They never moved out of Pune. They stayed in Pune. They had all their tax levied and a beautiful system to manage that, and they controlled Delhi. And they did that for several, several years. So we are very good organizers. And business today needs organizers. So if you're able to organize it, systematize it, then I think you're here to stay. So I think that is the basic difference. We are very organized, very compartmentalized. And you see our training from children. Maharashtrians have had a tough life, especially if you've come from the Konkan. It's so hilly. Even to get some drinking water, you have to have several miles of steep hill slopes to go and get it. So I think we are a sturdy, wiry lot. That is the difference. And that's what business needs. It needs someone who's sturdy. You not give up.
Thank you so much, Pratima. I would like to mention here that once upon a time, I quit my job in Tata's to be on my own. And I had empty pockets. And then I came to Pune. I was a Mumbaiite. I say, you know what? Pune looks lovely as compared to Mumbai. And when I came to Pune, I met Kirloskars because I thought, and I believe they were great people. And 5 years, they kept on giving me consistently business, which made me remain as entrepreneur. You know, you need conviction. You need some amount of money to sustain and grow. That was given by Kirloskar. And I had excellent, dealings with them. Never, ever I had a issue where ethics was under consideration, the money was delayed. So thank you so much, Pratima. I think I owe to you to a large extent my career.
No. We don't owe anything. We all come with our own karma. So we just do that and we go and we pay it forward. But let me tell you what happened in Kirloskar Wadi. You know, when the company was started in Kirloskar Wadi, they were S.L. Kirloskar's father, Lakshman Rao, said, let's start developing the business around it. So he tried to contacted the banks, and he had trained a lot of people. He said, you know, we'll spin this out as a business. We did that even recently in the 80s. We gave them some of our machines. And he said, you become an entrepreneur and you supply to us. So you become a subcontractor. Now, they did not have money. So we got Bank of India. And Bank of India has been our bank now for 70 years or 80 years, I think. And we have brought them to Kirloskar Wadi. So when we brought them, we said, Bank of India, we are going to buy this gentleman's product. Please give him a loan for working capital. And based on that, the whole banking system in Kirloskar Wadi has developed. And today, if you come to Kirloskar Wadi, it's a very wealthy area because that whole sugarcane belt has grown. We have done a lot of farming and irrigation projects with farmers there. So I feel it's up to each of us to create the ecosystem. Not always in business is it about taking. And, you know, my grandfather, S.L. Kirloskar, always said, you know, always remember, when you're doing business, your dealers have to be wealthier than you. Then they will give you business. If you are wealthier than your dealers, there's no incentive for them to give you business. And I thought that was a very inverted pyramid, but he was dead right. And that's how business really works.
Thank you.
Any other questions? Anyone else? Colonel sir, over to you. Back.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much. Before proceeding further, we have 9 guest participants. So I would like to welcome them from Rotary Club Pune Riverside. First, we have Pankaj Patel, District Director, Happy Village. Pankaj, warm welcome to you. We have PJ Master. We have Seema Anand, Jitu Meera Chandani, Suchitra Kale, Meena Late, Lata Kerkar, Swati Apte. Very happy and very warm welcome to all of you today morning and making it convenient to join the meeting so early. We have one Dost Dar. He is President Rotary Club 1 Unit JNK. So welcome Dost Dar to you also. So moving ahead, now it's time for formal welcome of our keynote speaker, Pratima ji. So I would like to invite Rotarian Aditya Mishra to do this honor. Over to Aditya.
Thank you, President. Thank you, Pratima, for taking us through the 100-year journey of Kirloskar. I think it speaks volume for a company who has done so much and so more without focusing too much on the bottom line, which you mentioned, which is profit. I think the journey from having a manufacturing a cycle to a pump and with so many variants, that speaks volumes. I think the few things that you have mentioned, and I think which could be a kind of advantage to the existing businessman, that the company keep investing in their people. And I think you have highlighted so many things that Kirloskar as a company doing. So you are very, very people centric. I think that's one of the key takeaway. Along with that, I think during the bad times, which you mentioned in year 2008, I think you have highlighted that managing cost is so much importance when you are running business. And I think the last bit, what you have mentioned, during Q&A, that inverted, where you don't mind dealer becoming more richer than you. I think that is something which is really, really amazing. And I think thank you so much. At last, I'm grateful to Neeru to connect you to our club. And maybe we will take this forward because you are equally active in the CSR activity, not only in India, but across the globe. I think the rescue operation you talked about, where it was not about the pump, but it was more about, knowing the terrain and how the water level is going to be, needs to be determined. I think that also speaks that you go beyond. And once again, thank you so much for joining us. And over to you, President.
Thank you, Aditya. Before proceeding further, in fact, I would invite Rotarian Neeru to say a few words on Urja. Urja is our one good project, and lot of people are now connecting with this Urja, and Neeru herself is conducting, so it would be better if Neeru speaks. So over to Neeru to say something about Urja.
Thank you, President. I will tell about Urja. Urja is not a classroom session which we are promoting from Rotary or Riverside. It is a concept that in every company or any organization, everywhere, I mean in each house, the concept of taking care of your own health should be created in the minds of people, which takes a long time and big efforts. And that is what I am promoting, connecting with companies and connecting with people individually. Mm. And it is happening slowly. People are coming forward to help, that they will at least bring 10 people who will be able to do this 1 hour regime of health with their family and themselves. And that is the success of Urja, that I want to spread this feeling through each and everyone. Thank you, President.
Thank you, Neeruji. And now I would invite Rotarian Umesh Jalan to say something about Sanjeevani Riverside. Over to Umesh Jalan.
Thank you, President. The Sanjeevani program we have designed this year, under the Sanjeevani program, we have the idea of reaching, giving soft training to the trainers, who are the teachers in fact. And they will reach out to the students with those kind of teachings which are apart from the routine syllabus, curriculum. So they will give the life learning lessons, they will share their experiences of the life learning, and lead the life in a better way, become a successful person, do something for, take care of themselves well, take care of the society well, take care of the state well, and thereby take care of the country and the world at large. So that's the theme with which we have started this Sanjeevani program, and it is going to continue, and we will be, say, planning to have at least 6 sessions in the year, whereby the teachers would be empowered, and as we go forward, we may scale up the program to a big level. So that is what the idea about this program, and I expect that from our club side, there should be greater participation and enthusiasm from the members, so that we take it to a good height. And so far as the program cost outlay is concerned, it is very, very cost effective program, and we are touching the lives of thousands and thousands of the students in turn to make them a better human being. Thank you all.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Umesh ji. Now we have Mr. Pankaj Patel, Rotarian Pankaj Patel from district. He is district director, Happy Village. So Pankaj, you would like to speak something about Happy Village? Over to Pankaj. Pankaj, can you hear me? No? Anyway, moving
Hello.
On. Yeah, Pankaj, please go ahead. Would you like to speak on something on Happy Village?
Yeah. See, what I meant to say, we have invited Swami Guru Gyanvatsal Swami to our club, and he has motivated our district for adopting village as a Vyasan Mukt, addiction free. And 75 villages we are shortlisting to start with this a small project, which doesn't require huge contribution from the club in way of funding, but the facilities are fantastic, and we can get a pride of Vyasan Mukt village. Every club I request should adopt at least one village, and our club members will help them, and the Swaminarayan Sanstha is also coming together for this. Recently, means we have visited 5 villages, and on Sunday we are inaugurating a Happy Village, including the project of Vyasan Mukt. So I wish that your club also should take up, and any assistance is required, we are there to help you.
Thank you.
Misraji.
Yeah.
Can I?
Yes, please.
More.
Yes.
So regarding that Sanjeevani project, I also invite the ideas of a very good motivational speakers who can come as a guest lecturer to train our teachers and share their experiences, to give some tips to the teachers as well as the students or the public at large, who can make their life better. So if you think that you have got some networking or the idea of bringing any speaker who can be helpful and whose is good at sharing the knowledge and experience which is out of the curriculum, you are welcome. You get connected to me. We will induct him as a guest speaker for our program. We have already enrolled, got a data bank of 600 teachers or so, and we are trying to scale it up further. So we expect that in any meeting, there would be a gathering of about 500 people online, and there would be many, many participants through Facebook, etc., which will run into thousands. So get engaged with me. Thank you.
Which language?
It's generally English and Hindi, because we are running the program on pan-India basis. So it's not restricted to Maharashtra. So we should avoid only Marathi language.
Great. Thank you. Thank you, Umesh. In fact, we have, as of now, we have data of around 750 teachers and around 7,500 students. And this data is through Google form, and everything has come as a file. And we are planning in a very big way. The most important thing, the focus is on empowering the teachers and students. So thank you, Umesh ji, throwing more light on that. So there is one more thing coming up, and this is a surprise for all the Riversiders. In fact, our youngest member, Janvi Hardas, has come up with another, under Sanjeevani itself. The one branch is for the teachers and the students, and other branch is for the, it's open. It's for teachers and students and others also, maybe senior citizens, maybe the, corporates, maybe Rotarians. So instead I talk about now, I invite Janvi to speak a few minutes, 2-3 minutes on her project. Over to Janvi.
Thank you, Mr. President, and good morning to everybody. Thank you, Pratima ji. I think everything that you spoke today was really motivational, and it gave us a true insight into not just business, but also ethics that follow with that. I actually would like to speak a little bit about the new project that we are planning to roll out, which is called Constitution and Us. Because of my law background, I think, for the past 5 years that I've been studying, I've always thought about how we as citizens know that there is a law in place, but a lot of us don't know what sort of laws and what sort of legal rights we actually have. So the main aim of the project is to bring people and the law together, so that everybody knows what their rights are and have proper remedies in case any infringement happens. So we hope to not only talk to students, but also adults, senior citizens, to sort of give them an idea of the Constitution, which holds most of our rights. So thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Janvi. And this we are going to take as a pilot project to our Happy Schools, Mother Teresa, Nutan Vidyalay Karadi, and Nutan Vidyalay Keshonagar. So moving ahead now, this thought of the week is the tradition of the Rotary Club Pune Riverside. So I invite Rotarian Vikram Puri to do this honor. Over to Vikram.
Thank you, Kanal Mishra. We've been hearing from the Kirloskars today. We've heard about the Sanjeevani program, Urja, our own Ganesh Natarajan runs, is part of an organization that provides education for youth. We've heard Janvi today talking about telling people about their rights under the law, and what to do if those are infringed. I think we are all beacons, and companies like the Kirloskars, all of these organizations that we've just heard, they're very enthusing and motivating. So I think they're all lighthouses. And why are they lighthouses? Because, and here's the thought for the day: a lighthouse doesn't run all over the place looking for boats and things to sail. It stands in one place, shines brightly, and attracts people who want to help themselves. And I think that's what this is all about, being lighthouses. So thank you. And that was your thought for the day.
Thank you. Thank you, Vikram. Thank you. Now, this joke of the day, or joke of the week, whatsoever you say, it has also been the tradition. And I invite Rotarian Sandeep Bass to do this honor. So over to Sandeep.
Good morning, everybody. Thank you, Kanal sir. And welcome, Pratima.
You are muted. Sandeep bhai, unmute yourself.
I am showing unmuted.
Yeah, now it's okay. It's okay.
Okay. So welcome and good morning to everybody. And thank you, Kanal sir. So it may not be so in Kirloskars, but most of the places, there's a tussle going on between HR and the employees. So one of these discussions, was getting heated, and eventually the HR person tells the employee, "Go to hell." So employee looks at her and says, okay, I'm very confused. Am I to stay or go?
Great, great. So thank you, Sandeep. Any other member want to say something? So please come out. Any other member? No? Okay, so once again, thank you, Pratimaji, for joining us today and giving a stunning talk on Kirloskar's 100 years. We have a lot of takeaway, lot of education, lot of learning on that count. Thank you, Janvi. Thank you, Umesh. Thank you, Vikramji. Thank you, Sandeep. And thank you, Pankaj Patelji, for sharing your your views on that. So not taking much time, it's time to, I'm going to declare the meeting adjourned. So meeting is adjourned. Stay healthy, happy, safe and blessed. Let's meet next Wednesday again, early in the morning at 8:30. So I have permission to end the meeting?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Deepak Bhai. Thank you all. Once again, very good morning.